Hello and welcome to the last video in the standard costing series, part five, our fixed overhead variances. And we're also going to be looking at reconciling these variances from variable and fixed to the total overhead variance. So my disclaimer and my copyright notice, the information and opinions in this presentation are those of the author only and not the author's employers or affiliated organizations, including but not limited to Irvine Valley College and the South Orange County Community College District. The presentation is for educational purposes only and does not constitute any legal or accounting advice whatsoever. This presentation is copyright 2008 to 2020 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. Any distribution is strictly prohibited. Presentations from time to time use information from third parties or the third party information. The third party information is the property of those respective copyright holders, and the author does not make any claim to the third party information. Okay, so our last video here is we're going to be focused on fixed overhead variances, which is really known as the spending and the volume variances. This is a little bit tricky, but we'll kind of go through and see how this works. So again, we're kind of working down the list. We're now down to our fixed overhead variance. So what we're going to do here is the first thing we're going to do is we're going to compute the total fixed overhead variance. And to get to this, we're going to have to kind of do a little bit of digging, but we should be able to figure it out. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to compute the total fixed overhead variance. Then what we will do is we're going to compute the fixed overhead spending variance and volume variance. And then we're going to do a check our work. One of the things I mentioned in video number three was in terms of this volume variance. And the reason why I've left this out here is X, as we'll see in a moment, that does not really have anything to do with what we actually paid for our overhead. So it's not going to be included in our check our work for the volume variance. Rather, what the volume variance is really a difference between how much overhead we applied versus what we actually had budgeted for. So let's go ahead and take a look at this right over here. So FSI had the following actual and fixed variable overhead costs during the month of October. 14,000 hours of direct labor were used to produce 30,000 shirts. And here we spent 210,000 on our fixed overhead. Going over here to produce one shirt, FSI determined that it would take 0.5 labor hours. FSI budgets variable and fixed overhead based on direct labor hours. Overhead rates are based on a production capacity level of 90%. Okay, this is very, very important. So the overhead rates, meaning how I'm going through and budgeting my fixed factory overhead, is based on a 90% production capacity. So let's take a look and see how this works. Okay, so when we're doing with fixed overhead, we're going to take our actual fixed overhead, which is going to be the 210,000, less our applied fixed overhead, which we do not know yet. What I do know is that my budgeted fixed factory overhead is 185,625, and this is from all levels. But this number is different than what we call applied fixed factory overhead. So let's take a look at this here. So my actual overhead was 210,000. And if I'm comparing this to figure out my total fixed factory overhead variance, what is that number going to be? Well, one of the things it tells us is that when it comes up with overhead rates are based on a production capacity level of 90%. So what this means is that when it comes and if I'm budgeting variable and fixed overhead rates based on direct labor hours, what this means is to come up with the rate for fixed factory overhead, what I am going to be doing is I'm going to be taking 185,625, which is the fixed factory overhead total budgeted, and divide it by the direct labor hours at that 90% rate. So if we come over here, the amount of the applied, so to figure out applied overhead, the first thing we need to figure out is what is our fixed factory overhead rate per direct labor hour. So I'm gonna take my budgeted fixed overhead of 185,625, I'm going to divide that by the labor hours at 90% production capacity. Why? Because the problem tells me so. That's how they're going through and doing it. So I'm coming up with $11 per labor hour. So what is my applied fixed factory overhead? It's going to be $11 per labor hour times the budgeted labor hours I had for my units produced. Look at the other videos. We produced 30,000 units. My budgeted rate per direct per unit was 0.5 direct labor hours. So I was using 15,000 direct labor hours. So my applied fixed factory overhead is going to be $11 times 15,000, or a total of 165,000. So when I compare this to my actual overhead of 210,000, I spent 210, my applied overhead was 165. So that total difference here is $45,000. So again, for fixed factory overhead, we've got to take another step. You know what the actual overhead is, but what I need to compare that to is the applied overhead to get to the total variance for fixed factory overhead. To get to the applied overhead, I'm taking my budgeted fixed factory overhead and I'm dividing it by the labor hours where it's telling me how it's doing its budget. So right here, it tells me that my overhead rates are based on a production capacity of 90%. If I come right over here, 185, 625, at a production capacity of 90%, I'm using 16,875 direct labor hours. So when it comes over here, it's $11 per labor hour. That's my fixed factory overhead rate per labor hour. I used 15,000 hours. Where did I get that from? I produced 30,000 units. 0.5 standard direct labor hour per unit, 15,000 direct labor hours. I multiply that by the rate of 11 and I get to $165,000. So if my actual amount of my overhead was 210 and the applied overhead was 165, did I spend more than I had applied? And the answer is yes, that's by $45,000. So, and that is unfavorable. So, what do I do next? I'm going to insert my middle value, which is my budgeted fixed factory overhead of 185,625. Where did that number come from? It was given to me right here. My budgeted fixed factory overhead was 185,625. So at this point in time, my total variance is $45,000 unfavorable. That's the comparison between the 210 and then the 165. Over here, my spending variance is the difference between what I actually spent versus what I had budgeted. So my spending variance is 210 minus 185,625, or 24,375. And I'm gonna, we could actually now check our work on that total overhaul over the total amount of the overhead, the overall overhead volume variance. We could do that right now. And the reason is because when I look at what I budgeted and I applied, these are really internal numbers. It's not what I spent. This is what I applied internally. This is what I budgeted internally. For this one right here, when we're looking at the difference between what did I actually spend on overhead versus what I had budgeted, I could stop right here. But let's just keep going. So my total fixed factory overhead variance is 45,000. My spending variance is right over here, is at 24,375. We spent more on our actual fixed factory overhead than we had budgeted. Now, the second part here is really a volume variance. If I take my budgeted fixed overhead and compare it to my applied fixed overhead, this difference here is 20,625. why does this difference exist? And the reason is that I only achieved 80% by making this 30,000 units. Had I achieved 90%, I would not have any variance here. So that's the reason why this is looking like this here. So again, just kind of go through and just kind of think about it. But again, this volume variance, which is the budgeted fixed overhead less the applied fixed overhead, is $20,625 unfavorable. I budgeted more than I applied. And again, it's because we did not meet our production capacity. Okay. So the last thing we're going to do with this type of problem is we need to check our work. Going back to video 3, what we saw that was the total controllable overhead overall cost variance was $33,625 favorable. So this $33,625 favorable overhead variance came from the difference between the total amount I spent on the overhead and then my budgeted overhead. Where is that number coming from? So this $33,625 favorable overall overhead variance. And let me just go through and check this right here. So this overall $33,625 favorable controllable overhead cost variance, or the overall overhead variance, what is this made up of? It is made up of both of the favorable, or basically both of the, it is made up of the variable overhead spending and efficiency variances of 20,000 and 30,000. Where did these come from? Go back to video 4 and check it out. We had a favorable spending variance of 20,000, 28,000, favorable efficiency variance of 30,000. Now, for this segment here, what is the other component that makes this up? It is the fixed factory overhead spending variance of 24,375, or what we actually paid for our fixed factory overhead versus what we had budgeted. That's a real number. So I include these three here, and this is how I check my work. What about over here? Why don't we use this part over here? Why aren't we using this 20,625? The reason why we're not using this again is this is an internal number. It's not what I actually spent. So over here, why don't we use it? It's an internal number. It's basically what we budgeted versus what we applied with regards to fixed overhead. And so therefore, this is not going to be a part of this breakdown in terms of the total overhead variance or the controllable overhead cost variance. So I want to thank you for joining me here today. If you have any comments, please send them to 1812cpa@gmail.com. Have a great day and a pleasant tomorrow, and I will see you on the next video series. Take care.